Friends, let us continue the discussion of terms related to prosody, part 2. Initial or beginning rhyme. In initial or beginning rhyme, rhyming words occur at the beginning of the separate lines. End rhyme. In end rhyme, rhyming sounds occur at the end of lines. Internal rhyme. In internal rhyme, the rhyming sounds occur within lines. Masculine or strong rhyme means a line ends with a single stressed syllable. Feminine or weak rhyme means ending of a line with an extra unstressed syllable. I or curtsy rhymes. In I or curtsy rhymes, words look like rhyme but are not really rhyme. I rhymes are not two rhymes because the real test of a rhyme is not the seeing but in the hearing. False and imperfect rhyme. Sometimes a poet out of carelessness or of a defective ear makes use of a rhyme which is mean and weak, as is and his. There are imperfect rhymes, or ugly rhymes, or uncouth rhymes, or bizarre rhymes, which offend the sensitive ear, as tease and peace, ready and steady. In the poetry of Scott, Byron, and Browning, one can find abundant examples of imperfect rhymes, but most often these poets have used imperfect rhymes for humorous and amusingly mocking effects. Slant rhyme, half rhyme, or off rhyme. In slant rhyme or off rhyme, there is correspondence of sound which has close approximation, as in real, bill, cave, have, room, glum. Alliteration. Alliteration is also called as a head rhyme. It is one of the devices of repetition. It consists in the use of the same consonantal or vowel sound in a line. It was a great feature of Anglo-Saxon poetry, and alliteration was in favor with Langland, the Elizabethans, and the Victorians. Assonance. Assonance is a kind of rhyme in which there is a correspondence only in the vowel sounds of the final syllables. The final consonantal sounds which follow them are not identical. Thus, assonance is a poor substitute for rhyme. It is a great instrument for producing word music. Assonance is not a regular feature of English poetry because it has been occasionally used in old ballads, and only in modern poetry it has found its place for producing melody. Consonance. Consonance is a repetition of consonant sounds within different words in proximity. It differs from alliteration only in that the repeated consonants are not initial consonants. Simile. Simile is a figure of speech in which a comparison is made between two dissimilar things which have at least one quality in common. Conceit. Conceit establishes a striking parallel, usually ingeniously elaborate, between two very dissimilar things or situation. It is also called far-fetched simile. It has two types. First one is Petrarchan's conceit, and the next one is metaphysical conceit. The Petrarchan conceit is a type of figure used in love poems that had been novel and effective in the Italian poetry of Petrarch. The metaphysical conceit is a characteristic feature in the work of John Donne and other metaphysical poets of 17th century. Epic or Homeric simile. It is formal sustained simile in which the secondary subject or vehicle is elaborated far beyond its points of close parallel to the primary subject. Metaphor. Metaphor is a figure of speech in which two dissimilar things are compared without using the words as, like, so.
Personification. In personification, inanimate, lifeless things are treated as if they are living beings. Apostrophe. Apostrophe is a figure of speech in which a direct address is made to a person or a thing or an abstract idea or imaginary object. Synecdoche. Synecdoche is a figure of speech by which a part is put for the whole for a part. The species for the genus for the species, the name of the material for the thing made, etc. In this way, synecdoche is a figure in which one thing is understood for another. Example for a part is put for the whole is 50 sail for 50 ships. Example for the whole for the part is the smiling year of spring. Example for the species for the genus is cutthroat for assassin. Example for the genus for the species is a creature for a man. Euphemism. Euphemism is an inoffensive expression used in the place of a blunt one that is felt to be disagreeable or embarrassing. For example, passed away is used for death. Confrontation is used for toilet. Euphony and cacophony. Euphony means the language which strikes the ear as smooth, pleasant and musical, whereas cacophony means a harsh, rough, unmusical language. Anaphora. Anaphora is the deliberate repetition of a word or phrase at the beginning of each one of a sequence of sentences, paragraphs, lines of verse or stanzas. Hyperbole. Hyperbole is an exaggeration of statement. Onomatopoeia. In onomatopoeia, the sound echoes the sense. Oxymoron. Oxymoron is a figure of speech consisting generally of two apparently contradictory or congruous words. For example, the fair cruelty, the noiseless noise. Litotes. It is an expression of an affirmative by denying its opposite. For example, he is not the brightest man in the world, and he is not a bad salt. Metonym. Metonym is a figure of speech in which one word is used with the intention that it will suggest another. For example, the word Neptune suggests the sea.
Zeugma. Zeugma in Greek means arcing. In the most common present usage, it is applied to expressions in which a single word stands in the same grammatical relation to two or more other words, but with an obvious shift in its significance. Sometimes the word is literal in one relation and metaphorical in the other. For example, or stain her honor or her new brocade. Rhetorical question. Rhetorical question is a sentence in the grammatical form of a question which is not asked in order to request information or to invite a reply, but to achieve a greater expressive force than a direct assertion. In everyday discourse, for example, if we utter the rhetorical question, "Isn't it a shame?" it functions as a forceful affirmative to the assertion, "It's a shame." Imagery is a process of making thought vivid by presenting it to mind in the form of images which stimulate the senses. For example, the images related to hearing are called auditory. The images related to taste are called gustatory. The images related to smell are called olfactory. The images related to touch are called tactile. The images related to heat and cold are called thermal. The images related to muscular tensions are called kinesthetic. Doggerel. Doggerel is an abusive term. It is applied to rough, poorly constructed trivial verse which has strong monotonous rhythm. It is lacking in dignity, which has satiric and comic effect. Dirge. Dirge is a piece of music, suits funeral. Poetic diction. Poetic diction is a distinctive language. It includes words, phrases, sentence structure and figures which are not in current ordinary discourse. Wordsworth framed attack on special language for poetry in his lyrical ballads. Thank you, dear friends. Let us meet very soon with a new video on a new topic. Thank you.